Slowly you are staying in Pandara Road?
Yes, sir.
How long?
I was there for 15 years. And after this form was filled, I shifted to Rabindranagar, which is...
After?
I shifted to Rabindranagar in November, but the form was filled till then. So currently I'm not staying there, but I stayed there for 15 years.
Your father is still serving?
Yes, sir.
And he's a deputy registrar in Supreme Court?
Yes, sir.
Deputy registrar is district judge level or?
It's the joint secretary level.
Joint secretary level. And he's a judge?
No, it's the administrative side.
So what's the job of your father?
So he's usually attached with a judge. So currently he's with Justice Sanjay Kishan Kaul. Whichever cases are coming to the Honorable Judge, they have to be allotted to various branches. Then a lot of documentation has to be done. So all the work that is done before the judgment is given, that is supervised by my father with a team of people. And after the judgment has been delivered, then after that also so many instructions need to be given to various stakeholders involved. So mostly that.
You follow the lot of judgments keep on coming? You have interest in this or no interest?
I do, sir. Yeah? I do have interest.
CGI, I think very recently told, still looking for prisons.
Sir, could you please...
Are you still saying to government, are you still looking for prisons to deliver?
Yes, sir. Yeah. The verdict, I believe it was... I remember this pigeon's phrase, sir, but I'm forgetting the exact context. Sorry, sir.
There's a lot of delay in release after bail.
Okay, sir.
The bail orders are not reaching to jail and all.
Yes, sir.
Because why, what they say? They say that we should be postal, through postal means we should get it.
Okay,
that's
sir.
Why he mentioned this.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
What are your views on that bail? Delay after bail order issue.
So it's a problem because it leads to congestion of prisons and it is also against the right to, let's say, liberty that humans deserve in the sense that they should only be imprisoned after they have been convicted. And this also causes overcrowding. This was also in news recently.
See, they are already in jail. Once court has given bail order that they should be released, there is delay in that. There is no question of congestion. Congestion is already there.
Okay.
I'm asking your views whether that delay can be cut short and what should be done.
So the delay should definitely be cut short, like the Honorable Chief Justice of India has said. In the sense that there needs to be a fastening of administrative work from the judicial side so that people are not held up for longer as possible and that we can have a speedy resolution of these cases as much as possible.
And you have done something with the Times of India?
Yes, sir. So this was their CSR initiative called Teach India. For 2 months, 6 hours every week, we would go to an NGO and teach 18 to 32 year olds English. This was English specifically for employability in BPOs, in shops, so that they could get jobs out of this. And it was an internship, sir.
It was useful?
I think so, sir.
And after? You got the feedback also after you get to them?
Yes, sir. They actually had a placement fair for them actually. So they got jobs out of it. And so it was useful for them, sir. And I think it was a personally enriching experience for me as well.
But 6 to 8 weeks they were able to speak good English?
So the basics they would need for the job. For example, if they're working as a receptionist somewhere, then the exact English one needs, that they would understand. And I hope then on the job they would pick up a lot more that was needed.
Have you heard of wildlife corridors? Wildlife corridors?
Yes, sir. So they are safe areas, so to say, wherein wildlife can move around, and usually basic commercial transport is prohibited in these areas. I had heard of this in the context of Karnataka, the whole Bandhavgarh tiger corridors. I've heard of it in the context of, but I'm not very
sure. Karnataka, Bandhavgarh.
I could be mistaken, sir. I'm sorry.
Okay, how the corridors are made? You know, what's the function of corridor?
So I believe it is to safeguard the wildlife, but I'm not very sure about this. Sorry, sir.
Okay, we have lot of surveys, Survey of India,
botanical survey, zoological survey. You know about that?
Yes, sir.
How many are there? Can you name another report?
The Forest Survey of India.
Mm-hmm.
Where it is headquartered?
I'm not sure, sir.
Okay.
The Mines and Minerals Survey of India. Yes, sir. Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall many.
You are reading newspapers?
Yes, sir.
Anything about Kerala? Last 2-3 days, Kerala news?
Yes, sir. With regards to their minority scholarship scheme that they had to redistribute. So it was previously given in an 80-20% to Muslims and Christians. Now, after the High Court had annulled that, they have refigured that to 60-40% for Muslims and Christians.
That is finalized?
I believe the government has decided that, sir.
Anything else? Some dowry that took place there?
Yes, sir. Dowry death was in news, sir, yes. But I don't know the details of the case. But yes, the conversation was about how, despite high literacy in the state, we do see such issues against women, particularly dowry deaths.
Somebody went on fast?
I don't remember, sir.
Kerala CM came to Delhi?
I don't remember details, sir. Sorry.
So how do you see the new president in the US and India-US relations?
Sir, India-US relations enjoy bipartisan support in the US. So most presidents in that way are in favor of having good relations with India, particularly with President Biden. I think given that he has rejoined the climate negotiations with the UN, the fact that he has consented to the Iran nuclear deal talks being revived and engaged with the EU and UK again, I think this will bode well for India's strategic interests, sir.
You said bipartisan, but yet we still have some, we had some irritations when it comes to some, what were all those irritations? How those irritations will be changing in the new regime?
The primary irritation with during Donald Trump's time was with economics, in the sense the GSP preference that India got, that was suspended, and the developing country status which we have at WTO, that is something the US had a problem with, our intellectual property rights. Those were irritants primarily. I think with President Biden already, USTR 301 probes has been called off against India. So I do believe there is some progress being made, and hopefully there will be engagement so that other prickly areas can be sorted out.
You said about GSP. What is GSP?
So generalized system of preferences, wherein a developed country gives tariff concessions to imports from developing countries or least developing countries like India, and even China claims this status.
Developing countries and least developed countries, or only least developed?
So I think India was also availing it, and India is a developing country, so.
They wanted to remove India from that list?
So because they feel that India, by virtue of being a member of the G20, is economically well off enough to not need these concessions.
Why should we have any qualms about it? One side, we say we are developing so fast, we want to become superpower, we will do this and that. And at the same, why should we go with the beginning power and don't treat as developed country?
So, I think the fact is that while we're the fifth largest economy in the world today, we recognize that that gives us some strength, be it geographically, be it in terms of our geopolitical position in the world. So yes, we are a powerful country, but we are also aware of the ground realities that we have certain small manufacturers, farmers who need these protections for India to progress into a much better space. And I think that's why we...
What is quantum relativity?
So, whenever I think something happens around me which impacts me in a particular way, which makes me think, I write it down. So it is called meditation on paper by some people, but essentially it's reflective. So it's called meditation on paper by some people. So for example, for me, whenever something happens, if it's an interesting conversation or a life event or anything, I like to write it down. It gives me perspective so that...
What way it is different from journaling, journal writing or diary writing?
Yes. So journal writing and diary writing are a subset of this, but in a journal and diary writing, the medium where you're writing is important, like a journal or a diary. This is a lot more flexible. Sometimes I will write on a Google document also. So I believe that is the difference.
And you were associated with the Center for Policy Research. What were you doing?
So they had a module called Education in India. And this was a 2 weeks in, 2 months engagement where they took us through the education policy in India. So I was engaged with that, sir.
What period?
So this was in 2019, July. July,
before
August.
The new education policy came.
Yes, sir.
What was your contribution in that center?
So it was actually a course. So my contribution was being a good student, perhaps. I was taught about what's happening, and we could also interact with some people over there, but I was primarily a recipient of information, sir.
What were the things you learned from it? Tell me 3 major takeaways from that course.
The first and most unique was how the relevance of traditional Indian schools of thought in education today, how we can harness that instead of just having a very...
For example,
in Shanti Niketan, Rabindranath Tagore emphasized on learning with nature. So today we have a very classroom-based learning, so perhaps a more outdoor-based learning, that's one. The second thing we learned was about how technology can be harnessed, and the government is already doing very well on that front. So second was technology. And third was how now we have reached good levels in enrollment. We need to work on outcomes of students. So a couple of diagnoses of what's going wrong and what can be done better.
How does the new education policy address these things?
On the first metric of traditional Indian thought, I believe the emphasis on regional languages is important and good. And also how certain courses in different types of traditions will also be provided in schools now. Secondly, on the idea of using technology in a big way, technology is being promoted, particularly in terms of interdisciplinary education. So that technical education is not just for the science students, perhaps even the humanities graduates can look into it. And third, with learning outcomes in a huge way. From the school level, the 5+3+3+4 model, vocational education, having round the year assessment instead of just once a year. So I believe there are quite a few steps which are being taken, sir.
What happened to the Ahmedabad railway station?
Could you please repeat, sir?
What happened to the Ahmedabad railway station?
The Honorable Prime Minister, I believe, inaugurated a revamped version of it, but I'm not sure.
How it was revamped? Why it is? It's a small. It's a railway station. Why the Prime Minister should inaugurate?
It's got very very novel technological innovation. Something about how above rail lines also there's a. I'm sorry, sir. I should have read up more on this. I don't remember.
Saloni Varma.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you tell me some of his contributions?
He was a painter from Kerala, and he's credited for being India's first modern painter, so to say. He combined Indian aesthetics with a more Western approach. So his painting of Goddess Saraswati is something I've seen. It's very beautiful. And those are the contributions I remember.
What is OPEC in news for?
The Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, sir. So recently, with crude prices surging across the globe, there have been calls for the OPEC to increase the supply of crude so that the prices can moderate. Particularly, India has been raising this demand. And right now, we see a standoff in the OPEC between Saudi Arabia and Qatar, if I'm not mistaken.
UAE.
Sorry, sir. Thank you so much.
What is the issue between the two?
So there was a deal to keep the oil supply at a particular low level in August of this year. And UAE has been saying that we should increase, but Saudi has not been agreeing. And there's another problem with respect to a quota that the UAE has, but I have to read up more on that, sir.
Why did you not opt for English literature as an option? Why SIR?
Sir, because I had studied literature for 3 years, and while it's a great discipline, I wanted to try something new. Moreover, I thought PSIR would help me understand the ecosystem we're in a little more better, in a more direct manner.
You wanted to try new?
Sorry, sir?
The honest response, you wanted to try me?
Yes, sir, because I had studied literature and I thought it would be nice to read something new.
Can you tell me some prominent contemporary Indian English writers and their works?
Anita Desai, Arvind Adiga, who wrote The White Tiger, Amitav Ghosh, who wrote The Shadow Lines, Khushwant Singh trained to Pakistan, and there are more, sir, but...
What do you read? Do you read English literature? What kind of books do you read?
I prefer non-fiction, sir.
What is the last book you have read?
It's called Rebooting India by Mr. Nandan Nilekani. It's about the journey of Aadhaar, which was like a startup within the government. I thought that was a fascinating
book. You had also written a book before that.
Yes, sir. It was...
Reimagining India.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
How has COVID impacted education in terms of dropout ratio, in terms of gender? Do you have any idea on that?
Yes, sir. So, according to the UN, the COVID could lead to a generational catastrophe in terms of learning levels, because so many children have been restricted from going to school, and technological access to education is not the best around the world, not just in India. That's first. Second, in terms of gender, because as family incomes have been decreasing, we see how girls are being disproportionately perhaps not being sent to school because there are not enough incomes available. And third, the role of education, which is not just schools and books, but it's also an emotional intelligence in the child that is being curbed, because online you cannot really always teach that the best. So I believe these three are the main impacts.
So would you engage in contemplative writing today?
I think so, sir.
What would you write about this interview?
So I would write about the fact that perhaps I had thought that I would pull down my mask and that would aid communication, but I think this is good enough as well. So I believe something new to look forward to.
Hi, Saloni.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. So 15 years in Delhi.
Who is Amrita, sir?
Recently, a painting by her was in the news. It sold very well. Amrita Shergill is a painter. She's also been a writer, I believe. And unfortunately, I don't know enough about her, so sorry.
But you travel daily in Amrita Shergill Park?
Yes, sir.
But you haven't studied about Amrita Shergill?
I should have, sir. Sorry.
So what are the problems faced by women in Delhi?
Pardon, sir?
What are the problems faced by women in Delhi, and what steps has the government taken for it?
Multiple problems. One is the crime, the rate of crime is fairly high. Second, in terms of labor force participation ratio, in Delhi it's very low, around 18% only when it comes to women. Third would be in terms of skilling and other such problems, I would believe. And fourth, I think the migrant women, that's another issue, because Delhi is a hub of migrants. What the government has done, I believe, on the women's safety issues, we see a lot of PCR vans, marshals in the bus so that there is safety, and training a lot of women in self-defense, so on and so forth, and sensitizing the police. Second, in terms of labor force participation rates, so they are trying to skill women. Government schemes, Saheli Samanvay Kendra scheme by the Delhi government, it promotes SAGs and groups of women so that they can get employed together. And for migrant women, so I think a lot more needs to be done. There hasn't been enough emphasis, but I believe the government is looking into it.
Can you name a few states which are pioneering self-help groups?
So Kerala. Manipur, Maharashtra, and that's it, so I can't think of more.
What about Tamil Nadu?
I don't have specific knowledge about
right, okay,
it, sir.
Okay. So, what is the role of opposition in a parliament?
So, I think the role of the opposition is to represent the voice of so many people, in the sense that any ruling party has certainly gotten support, but there are so many other people who voted for the opposition as well. So first is to give true voice to the people. Second is to keep a check on the ruling party, certainly, so that rash decisions are not taken. And third, I believe the opposition also helps to add to the quality of debate by adding more perspectives to a particular issue.
What will happen when there is no opposition, or when there is a poor representation of opposition in a parliament?
So checks and balances are vital for any party, any government. So I believe in the absence of an opposition, I believe hasty decisions could be taken, and enriching perspectives might be missed out on. So many people might feel that their views are not being represented because they might not agree with whoever is in power. So these things could happen, sir.
So do you think that the current, what you said, is happening in the present parliament today?
Not entirely, sir. I do understand why that may be a concern, but right now only, now that the monsoon session is about to come up, the government has been reaching out to opposition leaders for certain key topics. I believe the Honorable Defense Minister made an outreach, And I believe like the last session also the productivity of debate was quite high. So I don't think we're at that stage yet. So I think India is a vibrant democracy.
What does constitution say about the English language?
So according to Article 343, it is an associate official language of India along with Hindi. However, originally they had wanted it to be only for 10 years. Now it's been extended indefinitely. And the fact that I believe that is all the constitution says in terms of English specifically.
Okay.
See, India is a growing power and we are asking for representation in the UN Security Council. But you see, our Prime Minister is mentioning about the even United Nations is not a necessary thing in the present day because it's an outdated one. But still, we know lots of UN agencies in India functioning effectively. Why do we need UN agencies in this country? And what is the present role of UN? Do we need still UN?
So I think we need UN. The question is in which form? I think we need a better, more evolved UN, which is more representative of the developing world and which needs definitely a lot of work. In terms of what it is doing in India, I can specifically think of the World Food Programme of the UN, which has aided nutrition programs, particularly in Uttar Pradesh and other states. The UNDP also sponsors a few projects here and there. So I think it's good to have these agencies. They bring together the best of the world, the best practices in the world. They promote cooperation. And I think, sir, in a world which is more and more interconnected today, we definitely need the United Nations, sir.
Okay, thank you, Sunil.
Thank you so much, sir.
Your performance has been quite good. Mm-hmm. Okay.